answers are timid, my friend. They're born when the snow starts to melt and blossom when sweat beads fall. They can't be churned out like butter, but must age like cheese. In the desert, they lie under rocks. On the mountains, they're high on a crest. They're mixed in with confusion, 1,000 times their mass. One must pan them like gold, sift them like flour, or just listen. Answers are timid, my friend. They're so close, you can touch them from here. But you've got to know where to reach before that answer will ever appear. They hide themselves in corners, on shelves that are covered with dust, and they're in front of your eyes for years. They'll take you out sailing on a bright, windy day. Then they'll make you wait in a lull. Just when you think the wind has died, you're in a typhoon, and you must trust your timid answer who's at the helm. They'll coast on the surface for a while, till you think you see every one of them. Then they'll dive to the depths of the unfathomable unknown and won't even come up for air. They cling to their mother, Truth, who won't easily give them away. She expects a good dowry of love, labor, and obedience. Answers are timid, my friend, and they're slippery when wet. You can't hold on to them. The more you squeeze, squish, the further they go. You must skip along with them on the rocks of the river of truth, from conclusion to conclusion. They're reluctant to appear to the uncontrolled mind, but joyfully bounce to a brain that is ripe. Don't make the mistake of looking for them in new facts. Facts are just their clothes. Undress the old facts you know. Answers are timid, but not modest. Answers are timid, my friend. They're bashful and shy. They only come out for familiars and friends. Not the lazy, the proud, or the sly. Watch it, my friend. They'll change size and shape on you in a flash. So be careful. Don't box them into your expectations. They're liable to break the box or disappear inside. They go to those who will trust them, who'll take a chance on their worth, to those who hold them gently and won't squeeze them dry. The subtle ones are the hardest to catch because they're bigger, more mature. They can sidestep half-hearted attempts. Answers are timid, my friend, but bold when confronted by those with enough courage to seek them out in the caverns of adversity. And answers are good friends, because they're always leading you to new friends once they know you're loyal and patient. One answer waited a million years before he was found. He lived in an atom. Another lived as a human and is around, although the human is dead. People have talked of the human for years and need to discover his answer instead. Answers are timid. So be timid, my friend. Be an answer.